New at 5, we're getting an up-close look at the country's first offshore wind farm. Eyewitness News reporter Kim Kalunian toured the turbines on Block Island Sound today. She tells us what she saw and learned from North Kingstown with the South County Mobile Newsroom.
Those who took the boat tour from here at Quonset Point out to the Block Island Wind Farm got a chance to get up close and personal with wind turbines as tall as the Prudential Center in Boston. 3 miles off the shore of Block Island and 600 feet above the water surface. The 5 wind turbines of the Block Island Wind Farm are the first of their kind in the country.
We're literally turning the page and going into a new era of alternate energy.
On a boat tour Friday morning, U.S. Senator Jack Reed, members of the National Wildlife Federation, and laborers journeyed 16 miles from the mainland to get a closer look at the country's first offshore wind farm, 8 years in the making.
Not only great for the economy, but great for the environment. It's very impressive.
Deepwater Wind Vice President Matthew Morrissey says the 240-foot-long blades will begin to spin next month, generating enough energy to power 17,000 homes.
Block Island residents were paying up to 60 cents a kilowatt hour for power, and that power was generated by huge diesel generators in the center of the island. And those diesel generators were fueled by 1 million gallons of diesel fuel being ferried from the mainland to the island.
In addition to cutting the use of fossil fuels, experts say the turbines are eco-friendly.
The foundations are right now currently just coated in mussels, and so the sea life has kind of grabbed right onto it.
One thing those on the tour didn't see, the people working inside the turbines to complete last-minute checks.
As we speak, there are about 25 GE technicians in the nacelles themselves that we just saw today.
And Senator Reed tells us, although this is the state's first offshore wind farm, it's also likely to be the last built in Rhode Island waters. Reporting in North Kingstown with the Mobile Newsroom, Kim Kalunian, Eyewitness News.